So guys, I was wrong. Well, not quite wrong. You see, I actually just learned how to do something a little bit differently, and I like that method a little bit more than the way that I taught you guys in the past. But the reason why I titled the video in such a way is because I really wanted to start off with this lesson that has guided me in my career, creating my own individual style. Our styles, in my belief, are a combination of what we like about person A, B, and C in combination with our own personal taste, and a disregard of what we don't like about person A, B, and C. There are many different ways to get to the same endpoint with respect to cinematography and color grading. And although we have rules, we don't have to be so confined. With that, what am I talking about? Well, my friend Derek Morrison, who I met at NAB, he's a colorist based down in Orlando, Florida. He told me he loved my videos, which warmed my heart personally. But he enlightened me to a different way to color grade ProRes RAW Cinema DNGs. More specifically, actually, just Cinema DNG in general. Now, the way that I taught you guys, if you remember, is that when we go into our file project settings color management, we are working with a DaVinci YRGB color manage timeline with a custom color processing mode. And for our input color space, we select it same as timeline. Now, the reason why I taught you guys this method is because some menus get grayed out in the camera raw tab if you don't have same as timeline selected, specifically color space and gamma. And what would happen is that even if you had your camera raw default set up in your project settings, if you made some changes in the camera raw tab and you didn't like them and you reset that clip in the camera raw settings, it would default to a input color space and gamma in the camera raw tab of Rec 709 and sRGB, something crazy, and it blew out the entire image. And by having that set as same as timeline, it ungrayed that menu and it allowed us to select Blackmagic Design Film for both the input color space and gamma. Now with that, we did have to make some pretty extreme changes with respect to our sliders when it came to things like mid-tone detail, and we had a lot more control with our highlights and our shadows. But the method that I prefer a little bit more has the following changes. Instead of using an input color space the same in timeline, you're gonna scroll all the way to the bottom and scroll down to CIE XYZ. Now, if you remember in the videos when we were first talking about ProRes RAW and what raw data really is, it's a set of red, green, and blue values, not RGB, but red, green, and blue values, right? And that is what CIE is. It's that entire chromaticity spectrum. And then that has a input gamma of linear, which is what our camera sensors see in. Now for our timeline color space, you can keep this as DaVinci wide gamut. I've actually been using Arri Log C3 for my timeline color space, and I really like the results, but I haven't quite noticed a difference between the two. However, no, there is a difference in the working color space in and of itself. That's important. The other change that you are going to make in your project settings is going to be your input DRT. That's called Display Reference Transform. Now, if you want a little bit more in-depth information, it's on page 218 of your manual. But simply put, we don't need a display reference transform going from this linear data into our working color space because we're working in it. We do need a display reference transform from our working color space to our display. So that is going to be something like DaVinci or luminance mapping. After you go ahead and set up those settings, you are in a much better starting point, and you can go ahead and grade as normal. What I would recommend is that you also go ahead and tick highlight recovery. That is a necessity. And furthermore, just keep in mind that your shadow slider is going to have a lot of play. Your mid-tone detail slider is not going to be as pronounced, but your highlight slider is not going to have as much play. With that in mind, because of our display reference transform, those are going to be in pretty good places as it is. So just keep in mind when you're shooting, expose properly and you will be good. Always protect those highlights when shooting raw because your shadows are recoverable on digital. film is what is really good with highlights. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to give me a big thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, turn on those post notifications if you have not. Follow me on social media. The links are in the description down below. Leave me a comment with any questions and check out my live color grading course, Colorist HQ, as well as my store. The links are in the description down below. My beautiful people, now more than ever, if you are ever feeling uninspired, uncreative, or just want to give up on life, remember, every day, airplanes take off against the wind. Keep climbing, stay inspired, and as always, stay fabulous. I'm Sydney. I'll see you beautiful people next time. Peace out.